Hi everyone, welcome to the March 11th edition of Horses to Watch. I'm David Aragona. On the show this week, we're going to take a look back at three replays from last Saturday where horses didn't have ideal trips. I'll do two from Aqueduct and one from Santa Anita. Let's begin in New York with a race that took place on Saturday at Aqueduct. It was the fourth race on the card, a maiden special weight event for the three-year-old fillies going six furlongs. And I want to focus on a first-time starter, the number eight Brassy. Let's break it from the gate, and we'll start by looking at the head-on of this race. You'll notice that Brassy is going to stumble pretty significantly at the start of this race. She's going to basically go to her knees, and right after that, horses just swarm on both sides of her and basically totally squeeze her out of position. We'll pick it up again from the pan shot as they move down the backstretch, and she's just been squeezed towards the back of the pack now. She's the bay filly in those dark blue silks, those Godolphin colors towards the outside on the right of your screen. She's going to try to move up here, but she's just always going to be out of position and wide for this entire race. Just a pretty difficult trip for a first-time starter. Talking a little bit about her coming into this race, she's actually trained by Tom Albertrani, who's not a trainer who's really known for having first-time starters ready to fire first time out, but she took quite a bit of money in this race, which is not surprising given the fact that she was coming in off some pretty flashy workouts. She didn't show any of the speed that she had apparently shown in those workouts here, though. As you see, even coming to the top of the stretch here, she's still towards the back of the pack, just getting spun extremely wide. She's losing ground. She took a ton of kickback coming around the turn there. She's not going to really make much of an impact in the stretch here, but you see, she's still kind of green, lugging in a little bit. Just a horse who apparently really needed the debut. But as I was saying, she had some flashy workouts coming into this race. Apparently had shown some ability in the morning. Even looking up some of her workouts, I think she even outworked one of this barn's better older horses in the morning. So there's more expected out of her, and she didn't show it in this race. But I think moving forward, if she gets a clean start next time out, especially if she shows up in a race going a little bit longer, because she's by Medaglia d'Oro out of an APND Dam, who is a half-sister to Sky Mesa. So there's real class and stamina in this pedigree. She might even want turf in the future. I just think this is a filly that you want to follow moving forward, because she's likely to do much better with a cleaner setup next time out. Later in that Aqueduct card on Saturday, they ran a number of stakes races. We're going to take a look at one of those. It was the ninth race on the card, the Busher, one of the Kentucky Oaks prep races. We'll see if this race produces any starters for the Kentucky Oaks, but I want to focus on a filly who actually was a close second in this race, the number two Kansas Kiss. We'll break them from the gate on the backstretch going the one turn mile, and Kansas Kiss, she's going to get out of the gate just fine. She breaks with the field, and her rider, Eric Consell, is going to reserve her towards the back of the pack. Now, that's what you wanted to do in this race, because as they move down the backstretch, you're going to start to see some of the fractions get posted, and the pace of this race was just extremely fast. The favorite in this race, that 4-5 choice, Lake Avenue, is rushing up to take the lead here. She's not going to run particularly well, but a lot of that had to do with the fact that they're just going way too quickly on the front end. They go 23-1 for the opening quarter, 46 and change for the half mile. The track was pretty dead at Aqueduct on Saturday, so those were extremely fast fractions. If you look up the pace figures in Timeform US, they're just very fast. They really tail off as they continue in this race. Now, the number two Kansas Kiss is the horse that we want to follow here, because she was last for the first eighth or quarter of a mile, but her rider, Eric Consell, is going to move her between horses here and start to make this very early premature move up to challenge the leaders. I mean, they're just coming to the 3/8 pole here, and she's already up into second place, now moving past Lake Avenue. He's basically moving as if this race is ending at the quarter pole, but there's still a quarter mile to go by the time they reach the top of the stretch, and it briefly seems as if she's still going to win the whole thing, even despite moving so early. But as they get into the stretch here, you're going to see this filly who just took things over start to get pretty leg weary, and she's ultimately going to get cut down by the number six horse, Water White. But I still think the Kansas Kiss deserves a ton of credit for moving into the race at that point in time, because they were still moving at a pretty quick clip up front when she made that early premature rush into contention. And here, I'm not going to fault her for getting tired, because a mile, first of all, is probably farther than she really wants to go, and she exerted so much energy making that early move. I don't believe that Kansas Kiss is really a Kentucky Oaks kind of filly. I don't think a stretch out to 9 furlongs is going to suit her, but she did show some real one-turn ability here. So if her connections, Ray Handel and her owners, decide to turn her back to 7 furlong, 6 furlong types of stakes races, she's a horse that I would look out for, because this race didn't come back that fast from a speed figure standpoint, but Kansas Kiss ran much better than her speed figure would indicate. So she's a horse that I would look for in some stakes races sprinting for 3-year-old fillies in the future. Let's close things out by going out to Santa Anita to talk about a maiden race there from Saturday. It's the second race on the card, going 6.5 furlongs for the 3-year-old colts and geldings. And we'll focus on another first-time starter, the number 4, Believe Now, breaking them from the gate. And Believe Now is carrying those fuchsia and blue silks as they come out of the stalls. And he's just going to break a little bit slowly. He's just a bit flat-footed coming out of the gate, doesn't really stumble or anything. Just a first-time starter who didn't get away that alertly. There are a bunch of horses that are going to rush towards the front end. The pace of this race is fairly honest. But Believe Now is going out for a trainer, Mike McCarthy, who's not really known for having horses cranked up to win first time out, which kind of explains the slow break. And his rider, Joel Rosario, he's going to try to do all the right things here by aggressively trying to get Believe Now engaged in the race. And the horse is going to take him there right now on the backstretch. But you see, he's starting to get a little bit rank under Rosario. He wants to run up in between horses here, but there's really nowhere for him to go. He's surrounded by horses and behind them. So he's just going to have to wait for room here. And as they come to the top of the stretch, you're going to see these horses start to range up outside of him. Things start to get pretty cramped and crowded, and he's going to get steadied back here and shuffled back to be about 6th or 7th by the time they get to the quarter pole. And he's also down towards the inside, taking a ton of kickback. I mean, at this point in time, it looks like he's not going to even finish in the money or get anywhere close to it in this race, because he's just out of position behind tiring horses down towards the inside. But he clearly still has some run, and Rosario here is going to angle him towards the outside. And once this horse finds daylight, he just takes off again, and he's only going to finish 4th in this race, but he's quickly passing horses as they go by the wire. And if you go back and watch this replay throughout the gallop out, he actually runs by the eventual winner of this race into the clubhouse turn. So he's a horse who really finished strongly in this race and just never had any chance to run until the race was basically over. He is a horse who was a pretty expensive yearling. He cost $1.4 million in late 2018. He's by Uncle Mo, who gets any kind of runner. There's class in the female family. His dam's a half-sister to the stakes-winning sprinter Inspired. I don't get the sense this horse is a sprinter, though. I think he has more of that Uncle Mo influence, and he might want to go a mile or even farther in the future. He's definitely a horse who ran in his first start, like he'd appreciate some added ground. And given his trainer, Mike McCarthy, I think we'll see him do much better in his subsequent starts. And he's one who could eventually progress to stakes races. It remains to be seen, but I think this one could have a bit of a future. So those are all the replays for this week. I'll be back again next week to recap 3 more horses to watch.